Hi guys, in this video I am going to describe about process planning activities in a detailed way. Analyzing is examine something methodically and in detail, typically in order to explain and interpret it. Discover or reveal something through close examination. The first step in the process planning is to analyze the finished part requirements as specified in the engineering design. The engineering design may be shown either on an engineering drawing or in a CAD model format. The component drawings should be analyzed in detail to identify its features, dimensions, geometric tolerances, surface finish specifications, the material specifications and the number of parts required. The parts requirement defined by its feature, dimensions, tolerance specifications, etc., will determine the corresponding processing requirements, such as operations encompassing part shape generation, inspections, testing, heat treatment, surface coating, packaging, etc. The second step in the process planning is material selection and evaluation and process selection. The selection of a sound, economic material is another important aspect of process planning. The primary parameters affecting the choice of a material are: (1) function, (2) appearance, (3) reliability, (4) service life, (5) environment, (6) compatibility, (7) productivity, (8) cost. The process planner should evaluate the materials specified along with design engineers, based on the availability of manufacturing processes. Remove material. The first view is to consider the processing evolution of the part from the rough, that is, initial, state to the finished final state. In this view, like in conventional production shop, material is removed or modified on the rough part in stages in order to transform it to the finished part. Add material. The second view is to consider part evolution from a finished state back to a rough, initial state. In this view, in contrast to the first view, the operation processing is planned by adding material back onto the part. Selection of machines, tooling and work holding devices. Once the appropriate type of process has been determined, the next step in process planning is to select appropriate machines, equipment, tools and work holding devices to accomplish the required operations. There are many factors which influence the selection of machines. The following considerations are to be made while selecting a machine: economic considerations, due analysis should be made and should be selected. Production rate and unit cost of production. Durability and dependability. Lower process rejection. Minimum setup and put away times. Longer productive life of machines or equipment. Functional versatility, LE, ability to perform more than one functions. Calculating process parameter, that is selecting process parameters. After an appropriate set of machines required is selected, the next step in process planning is to calculate the specific operation setup times and cycle times on each machine. The determination of setup times requires knowledge of available tooling and the sequence of steps necessary to prepare the machine for processing the given workpiece. For establishing accurate setup times, detailed knowledge of equipment capability, tooling, and shop practice is required. The calculation of part processing time requires the determination of the sequence of processing steps on each machine. This activity is often called out planning. Selecting quality assurance methods. The inspection criteria has to be specified by the process planner for the critical processing factors, such as dimensional and geometric tolerances and surface finish specifications, identified during the drawing interpretation stage. In this step, the tools and techniques to be used for quality assurance inspection are specified clearly. The overuse of quality assurance methods and inspection would increase the processing time and hence the manufacturing costs. Hence the proper balance should be made achieving product quality and avoiding unnecessary checking. Next step in process planning is cost estimating. Cost estimating is the process of determining the probable cost of the product before the start of its manufacture. With the available cost and time data, The materials cost, labor cost and overheads are estimated. From this, the unit cost and the profitability of the product can be determined. If the cost data will influence the process plan to various decisions on what materials to use, and the manufacturing process to be used, the batch size to be used, make or buy a component. Next activity in process planning is process planning documentation. Having selected the best alternatives and associated machines, the next step in process planning is to document clearly all the information in detail. The resulting process plan is generally documented as a job routing or operation sheet. The operation sheet is also called route sheet, instruction sheet, traveler or planner. The route sheet lists the production operations and associated machine tools for each component and subassembly of the product. Route sheet usually provides the following information. 1. Part identification, numbers and names. 2. Description of the processing steps in each operation. 3. Operation sequence and machines. 4. Standard setup and cycle times. 5. Tooling requirements for each operation. 6. Production control information showing the planning lead time at each operation. Communicate process knowledge. The final step in process planning is to communicate the manufacturing knowledge to the shop floor through the operations sheet and process drawing. This communication is essential to ensure that the part will be processed according to the most economically possible way determined through process planning. Also, the process documentation and corresponding communication provide a basis for improved part consistency and quality in manufacturing. Thank you for watching. If you like this channel, subscribe Chennai Minds and comment below.